Happy Valentine's Day, y'all. It's the romance for me. Welcome back to Books with Kimberly. Don't forget to like, comment, share my channel, and subscribe. Today, I'm talking everything romance books, and not just romance books, but books that I enjoy that is all about the romance that makes me love them. I'm one of those people with every show, movie I watch, and every book that I read, I want just a little bit, a lot of bit of romance in there just to kind of get me through the book. I'm always looking for what characters are gonna connect and the sparks are gonna fly. It's all about the romance for me. When people bring up Hunger Games, I don't even remember what those books and movies were really about. All I know is Katniss had a choice between Peeta and Gale. Same thing for Twilight. I can't remember all the battles, the breakups. All I know is I wanted to know at the end, was Bella gonna choose Jacob or Edward? Because it's all about the romance. Do y'all get it? So today I'm gonna be talking about some of my favorite books that just gave me all the romantic butterflies, had me grinning, had me excited. You know, I like my romance to have steam, but it don't always have to be a steamy read. But I definitely want my romance to be cute, fun. I want dates. I want gentlemen. I just want all the romantic feels. And I want to be able to look at the couple and be like, they are so darn cute.
They just so darn cute.
Shout out to my nephew, Caleb. So I'm going to get right into it with one of my favorite genres, contemporary romance. The first book I'm talking about, y'all, is Imagine Us by Maureen Smith. When I tell y'all, I have read this book several times, and I really read it because I'm just in love with the main couple. I'm not going to go into too many details on this book, but there is an artsy girl and the high school bad boy. They got together, broke up in college, and this book starts off with her returning after spending over a decade in Africa, just getting away from him and starting a new life away from him. And when she comes back, she of course has to deal with those past feelings for her ex-boo, because he pops up a new and improved man, no longer the bad boy with the gold earring and gold chains. He has cleaned up. He is now a CEO working with children, and he is determined to win her back. I love this book, y'all. It gave me flashbacks into how they were in high school, and there were secrets, drama. This is one of my favorite romantic reads. A book that's very similar to this one is a book that I read last December, and it was included on my December 2020 reading wrap up, and that's Queen Move by Kennedy Ryan. It was also one of those books where the couple knew each other in grade school, high school. They spent some years apart, and then they came back together to see if that romantic relationship could work now that they are adults. I think this is one of my favorite tropes. I don't really know what to call it, but books like this really tug at my heart because I'm a sucker for teenage love. And then when you grow up and you're trying to, and those feelings just never ended, and all of those butterflies are just coming back to memory and all the reminiscing on the good old days that y'all had together. I'm a sucker for this. And another book that also has that same trope is Jennifer Weiner's Who Do You Love? I really enjoyed this book. I read this book years ago. I'm definitely going to have to reread it again because I just remember loving it. These two, the couple, meet in a hospital when they were children. They're pen pals. And throughout the years of breakups, friendships, divorces, it talks about how they continue to meet up, how they continue to, you know, have this bond, this relationship, and rekindle it, not rekindle it. And at the end of the book, you're just wondering, Are they ever going to get together? Are they ever going to have this loving relationship that you've wanted them to have since they first saw each other? Another book that I absolutely love is 32 Candles by Arnessa T. Carter. This is one of my absolute favorite books. I know I've been saying that a lot, but this is definitely up in my top five favorite books. Davey has a huge crush on this guy in high school. And he does not know she exists. But years later, when they are like halfway across the country, she runs into him, y'all, and the sparks fly. He doesn't remember her from high school, but I just think it's really cute. I mean, I don't know if my crush from high school knows that I exist, but I think if he would pop up like wanting to date the adult Kimberly, I would be here for it. I know some people on they Mike Jones, back then you ain't know me, now I'm hot, you all on me, and they don't want to be bothered with people who wasn't checking for them in high school, but I'm a hopeless romantic, y'all. Like, I would be here for it. I would forgive them. Like, it's okay. We can date now. You weren't ready then, but you ready now. Of course, y'all, I have to mention Get a Life, Chloe Brown by Talia Hibbert. I talked about this book all last year. Y'all know I am just here for Red and Chloe's love. Because Chloe had a chronic illness, Red was just so attentive to her. If she wasn't feeling her best, he was fixing her tea. What can I do to help you? She had her list of things she wanted to do in order to get her life together, and he was helping her with that list. I just love that. He was just emotionally there and physically there and mentally there. That's the love I like reading about. Even before the two characters say that they love each other, I just love to see it. Like, you can see it in the action. In this book, the way Redford was really there for Chloe, it just showed all kinds of love and romantic feel. The next books that are on my favorite romance books list are by Helen Hung. And these books are The Kiss Quotient and The Bride Test. I absolutely love these books, y'all, because not only are they steamy, not only is there Asian representation, but there is also autistic characters, which I thought was so cool and great. We got to see characters who are dealing with their autism, and it's hard for them to connect emotionally as well as physically, because we know some autistic people do not like to be touched. They don't like certain touches. They don't like certain environments. So to have partners that are so receptive of that and so caring and will do whatever it takes for that person to feel comfortable, that's just some beautiful love right there. So let's get into some young adult romance. I love romance in my young adult books. And when I think of young adult romance, I have to mention Jenny Hines To All the Boys I've Loved Before trilogy. I love these three books. They are about Laura Jean, who writes these letters during her young, youthful years. In her junior year of high school, those letters get mailed out to the different boys she wrote them for. And so she has to confront all those past feelings and these boys wanting to know all about her love for them. I absolutely adored this book. It was super cute. Also, when it comes to young adult, I think it's important that young adult books have that little bit of romance. Some people are like, the romance wasn't needed in this book, but I think romance needs to be in every book. For example, The Poet X by Elizabeth Acevedo and Monday's Not Coming by Tiffany D. Jackson. When I read those books, they were kind of heavy. So having that little bit of romance or hint of it was everything for me. And I think it gave a lightness to those books that was much needed when they were talking about some hard topics, some traumatic topics as well. A new genre that I'm reading is paranormal romance. I'm a huge fan of Karen Marie Moaning, and she has the Fever series, which I absolutely love. Paranormal romance, for those of you who do not know, is romance, but the books have sci-fi and fantasy elements. They're all about fae, vampires. Karen Marie Moaning books have the Seelie and Unseelie, but I don't care about all of that. All I want to know is what's going to happen between Mac and Barons, what's going to happen between Jada and Ryoden. It's all about the romance for me. Y'all get down in those comments and let me know some of your favorite romance reads. I'm excited to read those. Thanks for watching another Books with Kimberly video.